I welcome you all to the closing ceremony of the Mumbai International Film Festival. I welcome you all to the closing ceremony. Thank you, yeah. Thank you. Hi friends, I welcome you all to the closing ceremony of the Mumbai International Film Festival for documentary, short and animation films, MIFF 2014. This is a bittersweet moment. The fabulous atmosphere generated in the last week has led to great excitement about the much-awaited announcement of awards. But there is also a sense of sadness in the air about it being the last day of a wonderful and dynamic week. But before we begin the function, may I please request all of you to rise for the national anthem. As they say, all good things must necessarily come to an end, and we're not talking about the national anthem. However, the journey of the Mumbai International Film Festival is a continued one, and each edition is an episode that begins with excitement and ends with anticipation and assurance of greater promise in the times to come. Films Division of India and MIFF will continue to strive towards the creation of a robust, visionary and radical space for documentary, shorts and animation films. During the last 7 days, we have viewed over 450 films from nearly 40 countries. I think that deserves a round of applause. The experience was enhanced by lively interactions, group discussions, panel discussions, master classes, workshops and open forum. The intense activity at Good Pitch, MIFF Hub, the Producers Forum charged the festival atmosphere. This has indeed been an overwhelming week of viewing, discussing, brainstorming, and interacting. The video units of the MIFF team have been capturing the buzz at all the events. What better way to give you an essence of the week that has gone by than a visual collage? I invite you, ladies and gentlemen, to revisit the excitement of MIFF 2014 through a visual compilation of its highlights.
Thank you. फरवरी से 9 फरवरी तक चलने वाला ये समारोह अर्थात मुंबई अंतर्राष्ट्रीय फिल्म समारोह 2014, पिछले कुछ दिनों में इस समारोह में शामिल कई सारी फिल्मों को देखने के लिए दर्शक आते रहे। एनसीपीए के इस कैंपस में आज हो रहा है ये समारोह। एनसीपीए के टाटा थिएटर के इस ऑडिटोरियम में ये समारोह अब जारी है। समारोह का आज ये आखिरी दिवस है और आज ये समारोह संपन्न होगा अर्थात कई सारे पुरस्कारों के साथ। समारोह में शामिल होने वाले दर्शक, फिल्मकार और अर्थात कई सारे स्टूडेंट्स भी, इन सभी ने पिछले 6 दिनों से इस समारोह में प्रदर्शित होने वाली फिल्मों का आनंद लिया है। हर एक के लिए ये एक बेहद अनोखा, आनंददायक और अभूतपूर्व अनुभव होगा। समारोह में शामिल होने के लिए पहुंचे न सिर्फ वो लोग जिनकी फिल्में इसमें प्रदर्शित हो रही थी, लेकिन इस शहर के वो लोग भी जो कुछ खास चुनिंदा फिल्मों को देखने की ख्वाहिश रखते हुए इस समारोह में शामिल हुए, इस सभागार में शामिल हुए। टाटा थिएटर के अलावा गोदरेज थिएटर, एनसीपीए और अर्थात लिटिल थिएटर में भी ये फिल्में शामिल हुई, प्रदर्शित की गई। इसके अलावा मुंबई के ही अंधेरी में भी कुछ फिल्में दिखाई गई। अब से बस कुछ ही देर में देखिएगा वो एक खास फिल्मों का आकर्षण अर्थात एनिमेशन फिल्म्स।
एनिमेशन फिल्में मुंबई अंतर्राष्ट्रीय फिल्म समारोह 2014 का एक आकर्षण का केंद्र थी। ये फिल्में एनिमेशन के जरिए बच्चे बड़े सभी को लुभाती है और अब तकनीकी मदद से और भी आगे बढ़ी है। मनोरंजन ही के साथ एनिमेशन फिल्मों ने सभी तक सामाजिक संदेश भी पहुंचाया है। मुंबई अंतर्राष्ट्रीय फिल्म समारोह 2014 में शामिल थी ध्वनि देसाई की फिल्म चक्रव्यूह। आरटीआई सूचना का अधिकार पर भाष्य करती हुई ये फिल्म थी।
ब्रिगेंजा सरकारी अफसर था, मर गया, छोड़ बीवी बच्चा, बड़ा दुखद अवसर था। मुआवजा, पेंशन और नौकरी की तलाश में बीवी गई ब्रिगेंजा के दफ्तर। सब मिले यही आस में, कोई मिलेगा मदद करेगा, पर नहीं मिला कोई साथ।
I filed a couple of RTIs. There were some illegal major repairs in my building, and the way things were moving, I realized that with complaints and things like that, things won't move. I came to know that the entire repairs that were there were completely illegal. That was my first success with RTI.
मोहम्मद भाई को बिजली, बिजोए को जमीन का हक और पिल्लई को सफाई। सूचना के अधिकार आरटीआई की ताकत ही इतनी है।
इसके अलावा शहरों की जिंदगी पर आधारित कुछ फिल्में शामिल थी। नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ डिजाइन की फिल्म गुड मॉर्निंग मुंबई, मुंबई की झोपड़ी में रहने वाले इंसान की सुबह जताती हुई फिल्म थी। साथ ही पुनरारंभ, ये भी एक एनिमेशन फिल्म थी जिसमें एक मध्यम उम्र का आदमी बड़े शहर में पैसा कमाने जाता है, उसी की कहानी।
Good evening and a very warm welcome to all of you. Worthy chief guest, Shyamji, our guest of honor, Adurji, you have always been amazingly good to Films Division and have come to our aid on innumerable occasions. It is indeed a huge pleasure for the whole MIF team and a privilege, I'm sure, for the winners today to to receive their awards from you. As MIFF draws to a close, I find my heart is a cauldron of conflicting emotions and feelings. There is elation at the festival having gone so well, and a depression that it is now coming to an end. A rush of adrenaline from all the excitement and electricity in the atmosphere, and a sense of calming relief that no major glitch happened. When the MIFF team started preparing for this edition, we laid down three doctrines for our guidance. First, participative, in planning as well as execution, through extensive involvement of volunteering organizations and individuals. Second, that we must make MIFF a worthwhile experience for all participants by intensely targeting value in the program and the content. And third, that we must break new ground in many aspects of MIFF while staying within the budget available. Hence, the Lenap Kids Film Festival, Shehernama, Good Pitch, MIFF Hub, Producers Forum, the Unconference on Audience Development, and a number of other activities that we took up. I'm glad to report a moderate to resounding success in all the ventures. Many people in the festival congratulated and thanked the MIFF team in amazing terms. We are deeply grateful for that appreciation. Some even came and apologized for having criticized us initially for mishandling, which is normal, and shared their beautiful revised opinions with us. So what can be more heartwarming for the whole MIFF team? I'm not suggesting that we organize a perfect festival. No one can. Besides, it would be really boring to do that. I mean, if you organize a perfect festival, what would you look forward to improving in the next edition? So thankfully, there are still many areas where improvement is needed. We just experienced one. Some of it stuck. And we have our work cut out for the next edition, I'm sure. For example, I'm told most of the films were brilliant, although I didn't get to see any of them. But allowing mixed screening formats led to mixed quality of screenings. And what happened just now was also that mix-up. Also, I'm told some screenings should have been supplemented by a generous supply of tissue to help the tearful audiences. One such film, I think, on John Lennon was screened today morning. But on a serious note, can you do help us by providing your feedback? It's very simple. Just go to the website, www.miff.in, click on the feedback button, and express your opinion. There's a prescribed free format there if you want to use that, or just shoot a mail to us. We shall take it into account when we take stock of this edition and when we start charting our course for the next edition. It's very important, and therefore kindly do it while the memories are still, I mean, good or bad, while the memories are still sharp. Films Division of India launched MIFF with the objective of promoting cinema culture in our country. Let me share with this august audience that what drives the Films Division and the MIFF team to work so hard is our appreciation and love for the independent filmmakers in the country and outside. We love you. That is what makes us go the extra mile. In that spirit, Films Division is setting up the National Museum of Indian Cinema. We are also in the process of setting up industry standard infrastructure for digital filmmaking, a color grading facility, a DI facility, a 5.1 surround sound mixing studio, a high resolution digital library of Indian sound effects, and preview theaters. We propose to share all of this infrastructure with independent filmmakers at a very nominal cost. A few months ago, the guest of honor for today, Adurji, inaugurated the Archival Research Center in the Films Division, which houses 15 workstations to help research the archives of Films Division, digitized and hosted on a server. We plan to set up in the same center a digital library of documentary films from all over the world. This facility is a completely piracy-proof offline setup, and I request all filmmakers to donate liberally digital copies of their films to the library for viewing by scholars, students, and film lovers. In the coming months, we propose to develop the Films Division complexes in Mumbai and Delhi as hubs of good cinema. In Mumbai, we shall have, at the end of another year perhaps, 5 theaters, a museum, a multipurpose hall, food courts, exhibition and gallery spaces, and lots of open congregation spaces for cinema lovers to come and, as the youngsters nowadays say, chill. So I invite all of you to use the facilities and to make it a truly chilled out public space for cinema in the city. Films Division and MIF have always been supported by filmmakers in the country and outside. A tremendous amount of goodwill is enjoyed by us, which we hope shall be continued as we renew our efforts to become more efficient, better organized, and more useful to the film community. I hope you had as great a time attending this festival as we did putting it together. Hundreds of volunteers and numerous organizations have labored for months to bring you the MIF experience. All the credit for this amazing week goes to every single contributor. And for all the glitches, one man is responsible. Anyone throwing eggs, tomatoes, or shoes, I hope not, should aim for the festival director. And now I pass on the mic to Swara, and I want to go into hiding. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Tell us the truth, you're not going into hiding, you're going to sleep. May I please request Director MIF to welcome our chief guests of the evening, Shri Shyam Benegal. Our chief guest of the evening, sorry, Shri Shyam Benegal, and our guest of honor, Shri Adur Gopalakrishnan, on stage, please. They, like all great people, need no introduction. The impact of their vision and oeuvre on Indian cinema has made them household names in the country and heroes in the eyes of cinema lovers. Both these great people represent so much of what is right and wonderful and tremendous about Indian cinema. We're extremely honored in having these two legendary and iconic filmmakers who have redefined cinematic language of Indian films here with us today. Thank you, sirs, for your presence. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now approaching the most awaited part of the evening. And very special for me because I'm normally on that side of this part of the evening, so I'm feeling very privileged and powerful today. MIF 2014 has had the privilege of having two outstanding panels of jury who have patiently and with dedication and rigor arrived at their verdicts. I take immense pleasure in inviting on stage the members of Jury 2. I welcome Mr. Mark Akbar, one of the most important documentary filmmakers and political commentators in the world today, whose film, Manufacturing Consent, which he co-directed with Peter Winternick, remains a landmark in the documentary, in documentary filmmaking. Ms. Radha Sesik is a filmmaker and programmer working with a number of international film festivals. I also welcome Mr. Amitabh Chakrabarty and Mr. M. R. Rajan, two extraordinary filmmakers from the country, and the celebrated cinematographer, Mr. Piyush Shah. To give you an idea of their eminence, the combined experience of this jury is over 150 years old. Really? I now call upon the jury chairman, Mr. Mark Akbar, to please address the House.
On behalf of our jury, I want to thank Mr. Kundu for selecting us for this honor. It was a pleasure and a privilege to view and discuss all the films with my fellow jury members. Each brought a wealth of experience to our task. The films we saw opened us to diverse cultures and ways of seeing. there were stark contrasts, dark corners of society against lighthearted fantasy. Intolerance and homophobia was offset by love in all its forms. Oppressive patriarchy failed to stifle strong women's voices, both as subjects and as filmmakers. Some filmmakers worked with the most rudimentary resources, but produced remarkable results. The subjects and approaches were so varied that we regret there weren't more categories to honor more films. We arrived at our final choices through consensus, and that worked remarkably well. But we did have one problem. Two very different, important national films of exceptional quality emerged as contenders for best documentary over 40 minutes, and we struggled to pick one over the other. After lengthy, frank, but ultimately non-violent discussions, there was only one solution that, while not ideal, felt right to all of us, to award both films and split the prize money. I come full circle tonight, having had the thrill in 1994 of winning with my late friend and co-director, Peter Wintonek, a golden conch for our first film, Manufacturing Consent. The prestige of that award helped propel our film and our filmmaking careers, and the jury is delighted to do the same for all the filmmakers we are awarding tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your valuable comments. May I now request permission of our chief guest, Shri Shyam Benegal, and our guest of honor, Shri Adur Gopalakrishnan, to begin the award presentation ceremony for MIFF 2014. Would you like to speak first, sir?
Before the awards.
Now that I don't have my dialogues and text, let me invite Shyam sir, who I've had the privilege to be directed by very recently. May I please invite sir to come and say a few words.
Good evening. It's a great honor and delight to be here at the Mumbai International Film Festival for documentary short films. And it's growing year after every alternate year when the festival happens. But from the time it started to now, I find that the quality of films is probably getting better and better and better. And it's a bit sad that I haven't been able to catch any one of the films that were shown here this year, which is really, because, you know, it's my loss, because I should have found ways of getting here to see some of those films, which I've read about when they were covered in the press, but I haven't been able to see them. But what is marvelous is that Films Division, which is handling this, is doing a really wonderful job of putting this festival together each alternate year. And I think Mr. Kundu has taken a great deal of interest in this, which is wonderful. Also, you know, there are other things, because I have my own views about what Films Division should be doing and has not been doing and so on, but that's really not, this is not quite the forum to talk about it. But I was delighted to hear that Films Division actually continues to produce about 100 films annually. And because, you know, I hope and wish that many of us who never get an opportunity to see the films would be able to, because we don't seem to have the right kind of venues for the films that are made by Films Division for the general population to see them, because not many of them are actually shown on any of our television channels, even the national channels, I don't think, show too many of these films. Now, it is, I mean, quite honestly, I feel that Films Division should concentrate on making longer films, films that deal with subjects in some depth. Now, we have Anand Patwardhan here, who's a brilliant documentarist. Now, the kind of films that he makes, which are exploratory, which deal with subjects that are not only important, but forever topical, because the subjects he deals with, those kind of films, we need to constantly keep making, I feel, and there are young filmmakers who want to make films like that, but don't really get the opportunity to make them. And I think Films Division should really concentrate, not see itself as an organization of the government, but see itself as a documentary, an institution for creating documentaries regardless of the government. Although the public taxpayer, you know, the tax, it's public money. If it is public money, it should be spent for the public, but it does not necessarily mean that it has to be done for the government of the day. So I personally think that Films Division can do a great deal. I've been seeing Films Division for a very long time. My very first film that was distributed by Films Division was made in 1962, that's 52 years ago. So, you know, I've been watching how it has developed. It went into a wonderful peak in the late 60s and early 70s. Then it has been into a kind of gradual decline until the government of India really didn't care about it by the early 80s when television came, and you know, with television, everybody forgot about Films Division. They only saw it as a little building sitting there on Pedder Road in Mumbai. You know, but I think there's a lot there, there's a great deal of potential, but it requires for the government to look at it as an institution that really reflects not only the work, the kind of work that filmmakers themselves make, but also reflects the kind of, you know, it should feel the temperature of the time, you know, of its time. And that's what documentaries really should be doing. And I think there is that opportunity still, and there are filmmakers who are doing it against quite considerable odds, because, you know, I see Anand Yakod in front of me all the time, because he has been doing this. I don't know how he manages to, but he continues to make film after film after film, which make a lot of sense. I don't think I have very much more to say, except to congratulate all the winners of this International Film Festival here. Congratulations to you all, and I hope you continue to keep making films, because it's a wonderful thing. I love the movies myself. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. May I please request our guest of honor for the evening, Sri Arur Gopalakrishnan, to please give us his address.
Honorable guests and friends, I don't know why, while sitting on the stage, suddenly an incident came to my mind, because I have attended several festivals in this country and also outside this country, but some of the things that I remember, the most interesting things that happened were in India. And one of them was, there was this festival in Delhi, IFFI, not documentary, feature film festival. And I remember I had just arrived that morning in Delhi, and then there were very young girls armed with a microphone and supported by a television camera. They were chasing people around. So I was myself rushing to see a film, and a couple of them tried to stop me and then wanted to take a bite. They call it bite. So I said, I'm going to see a film. You come when I'm free. And I did not want to talk to them when I had just arrived, and I did not have a real taste of the festival. So it went on. So after the screening, when I came out, the same girl who approached me again came and said, sir, I want a bite from you. Then I said, maybe I can tell a joke and then send her away. So look, my dear girl, I don't bite young girls. Then she, I don't think she understood what I said. She disappeared for the time, and I rushed to see another film. So by the afternoon, she had this unexhausting enthusiasm. And by the afternoon, around 4:30 show or something, I came out, and then she was still outside waiting in the lobby. She said, sir, can you give me this bite now? I said, okay, what do you want? Then I told her, look, when you go to a festival, people, particularly the television people, they come to interview you. Even if you tell them, this is my first morning, I'm yet to see films, and I cannot talk about the festival yet. Invariably, they all ask you the same question. What do you think about this festival? What am I to think about this festival? No, let me see. You know, at the end of the festival, maybe I can say whatever films I saw and what I thought about it. So she was very unhappy with that answer of mine. And then again, she insisted, sir, I want you to talk about. Then I, as a person much senior in age, I told her, look, if you want to continue in this profession, never go and ask anybody the same question again. What do you think about the festival? Don't do that. You know, this is not something you can judge from the outside. You know, you have to have some interest in cinema. You yourself should know what is being shown. Have some primary education. So I felt maybe next time, Mr. Kundu will please consider my request. Next time, please have a small little course before the festival starts for the young critics and reporters. How to look at films, how they are made. You know, recently a great filmmaker died 2 weeks back, Miklos Yangcho. Most of you may have heard about him, seen his films, starting with Roundup. He started late in his life. He had interest in cinema, but then it was at the age of 45, he went and joined the film school in Budapest. This man made some of the most amazing films in the history of cinema. So recently he said he started with making documentaries. Then next sentence was, I thought, very important, because he said, no, I disowned them all because they are all fake. So when I read that, I was very surprised, because how could somebody like Miklos Yangcho say that? The fact was, he said, I had employed actors, I had staged sequences. But there was a time when everybody thought documentaries should have just direct recording of the everyday happenings. But that notion has been changed, I must say, because it is possible. Because what is important, I think, is not the superficial reality, but the inner reality of the thing. There is very hardly any difference between feature and documentary in that sense. So a festival like this shows our audiences that you can be extremely creative and entertaining, you know, in documentaries. There have been great documentary filmmakers. You know, one of the great examples is the National Film Board of Canada and filmmakers like McLaren and a whole lot of them. It's again a governmental institution. But what they did, they reached the zenith of creativity, a governmental institution which we don't associate with the governmental functioning. But this is exactly what happened. And for a long time, particularly during the period of John Bhavnagiri in Film Institution, we all thought that Film Institution was having a glorious period. It was winning international awards for experimental films and all kinds of films. He encouraged, you know, every field. So that period was also over. So from time to time, the aims and objectives of the Film Institution keep changing. Some people think at the decision-making level, think the only idea of documentary or the short film is to propagate government's achievements, not even reaching the people with ideas of progress, what development is required, etc. But then it's always information which you have to swallow. You cannot question it because there is no interactive process. So, but Film Institution at the same time, even with all its drawbacks, it has been producing films, particularly in the area of arts, many films, very many films. Most of the arts in India, both traditional, folk, etc., there have been films made. But what with one drag, that is the film has to be, the short film has to be of less than 20 minutes. You make a film with much care and very many subjects require a lot more length. But in the Film Institution, the allowed length is maximum length is 20 minutes. But you make a film within 20 minutes or 19 minutes. I'm talking about the old days. When you take it to Film Institution, there is another board, approval board, film advisory board, which looks at it and says it can be cut down to 13 minutes. We don't know what is the criteria. How they arrived at these 13 minutes, why not the next 5 minutes, we don't understand. But that is final. Once they say that, even God cannot change it. So you end up making a film on Kathakali, where to have one padam sung or shot, it will take several minutes, several hours sometimes. So you can hardly, they become tableaus in the end, you know, with the FAB cutting, etc. These films become tableaus. You show one scene there, here another, like that. So that, and that was also the time when Film Institution had the virtual monopoly of documentary filmmaking in this country. In fact, the short film became synonymous with documentary. You cannot imagine, in those days we could not imagine a documentary exceeding 20 minutes. So all that changed with the change in the technology and the new awareness that was there in this country. With the digital technology becoming popular. Now the problem is every film is a long film, longer than feature films, because in the feature film people don't wait for more than 2 hours inside a cinema house. If it exceeds that length, they will get up and walk away. So here there is no such problem because no theater ever shows any documentary in this country. So it is for just for the love of making it that the filmmaker does it, and he does not know where to make it short. So it goes on. So we are at the two ends, in fact, in terms of the problem. Where you? So I'm sure, you know, more than making films, somebody like Mr. V.S. Kundu, whom I thought was in a bad situation when he joined the film institution. That was a time when we all thought, you know, the film institution had its great days and it is over and it's going to be wound up any time. But now, film institution is getting into a new stage of life. And we all have great hopes about film institution. As a democracy and as filmmakers who have the right to talk about subjects that they feel free about expressing, I think it should be encouraged by the film institution. And it is not a question of the government only. You know, we also have to talk to the government and to the people. So I did not wish to talk at length, but then I have a very emotional relationship with film institution. I started with my documentaries with the film institution. So I'm sorry for being for far too long. And thank you very much, and let me wish the festival all success. And let me also congratulate all those who have won the awards. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now, with the permission of these two legends, we begin the award presentation ceremony for MIFF 2014. And I would just like to say that MIFF has been very generous, and we have today up to 34 awards, including special jury mentions as well. So, let us begin then, ladies and gentlemen. We shall start with the national competition, which consists of the categories of short fiction films, documentary films up to 40 minutes, and documentary films over 40 minutes. We begin with the Short Fiction Film Awards. This category has three technical awards, each carrying a certificate and a cash award of rupees 1 lakh, that for the best cinematographer, the best editor, and the best sound. The jury citation for the best cinematographer says, the winning cinematographer took on the challenge of a story with multiple tones and layers and succeeded in uniting them all in a beautiful and restrained approach. The award for the best cinematographer goes to Sahir Raza for Tamash Puppet. Let us please watch a clip from the film. May I please request Shyam sir and Adur sir to please remain on stage to give away the awards, and may I please ask the jury to take their seats, please. May I please request the jury to take their... No, thank you. Shyam sir, this is a very rare moment when I get to ask you to do things. For the Best Editor Award, the jury had picked, and I quote, a dynamic, lucid film that uses the magic of cinema to remind us of our remarkable natural ability to observe and make sense of the world unaided by technology. The award for the Best Editor in Short Fiction goes to Ram Reddy for Ika, Feather. Clip, please.
માટે નીકળ છો પેના
એમી
પિક્ચર જે તમા
પિક્ચર తింటే పోయి పంతో
అది కాదురా సుశీల మీ చెప్పిన కెమెరా కెమెరా
I invite Ram Reddy to please come on stage to receive the award for the best editor in the short fiction film category of the national competition. Thank you, Mr. Reddy. You may not always be aware of good sound in a film, but if it's not good, you'll notice. Good sound serves a film's dramatic points and underlines its narratives. For their precision in enriching a complex and imaginative story, the award for the best sound for short fiction goes to Yatin Dhabi, Manoj Sikka, and Abhishek Bhattatiri for Tamash Puppet. Let us watch a clip from the film, please. I invite Yatin Dhabi, Manoj Sikka, and Abhishek Bhattatiri to come on stage to receive the award for the best sound in the short fiction film category of the national competition. And now, the golden conch for the best short fiction film in the national competition. And the jury citation reads, in a funny, scary, and engrossing film, multi-layered insights weave an allegorical tale. From conception and through every element of production, this finely crafted gem succeeds in every way. The golden conch for the best short fiction film in national competition goes to Tamash Puppet. By the director-producer team of Satyanshu Singh and Devanshu Singh. Let us have a clip from the film, please.
کرن مے کلاس مے وہ نگن مے کوئی مدد کر
I invite Satyanshu Singh and Devanshu Singh to come on stage to receive the golden conch and a cash award of rupees 3 lakhs for director and 2 lakhs for producer which in this case is going to be shared by the duo who I believe are also brothers I know are brothers May I please ask the Singh brothers to come and say a few words? Okay.
Good evening and thank you so much. Thanks to the jury for, I think the competition was really tough. I have watched at least 12, 13 of the films in competition and I really felt that losing to some of these films would be okay, you know. Because there were some really good films. And, you know, but this is a sentiment which filmmakers can understand. For all friends and well-wishers and hundreds of people in Bombay and in Kashmir.
This means a lot.
This means a lot, and the way they have helped us in every stage of film of the making of this film. This is our first professional film, and to receive this award, I think we would receive this award on the behalf of all the people in Kashmir who helped us without any expectation. We shot in their houses. They treated us as guests. We still remember the wonderful kahwa that they offered us all the time. So it is actually to the people of Kashmir, the children of Kashmir. The film, we consciously stayed away from any political connotation in the film because we wanted to tell a story which could be a beautiful fable set in Kashmir. So I hope at least, you know, we can take this moment to hope and pray that things will improve in the valley. Thank you so much.
Friends, we now come to the documentary section of the national competition. The competition in this section was truly tough, and the esteemed jury felt compelled to award a certificate of special jury mention in addition to the awards announced earlier. There are three technical awards, each carrying a certificate and a cash award of ₹1 lakh, that for the best cinematographer, the best editor, and the best sound for documentary films entered in the national competition. One film stood out for a special jury mention. The citation reads, "This film embodies the passion and dedication of its star, a unique and compelling man, Mr. P.K. Nair. It is a witty and thorough love letter to cinema, Indian culture, and the virtues of tenacious individual effort. The film Celluloid Man by Shivendra Singh Dungarpur has won this remarkable honor." Let's have a clip from the film, please. Next clip, please.
History of cinema, or encyclopedia of cinema, or archive of cinema, which he created in Pune. His name should be like Dada Phalke.
Mr. Nair is, for me, a symbol of memory of cinema.
May I invite, who I know is one of cinema's most sincere lovers, the passionate and indefatigable Shivendra Singh Dungarpur, to please come on stage to receive the certificate for a special jury mention in the documentary category of the national competition. Shivi sir, or any... We have the man himself, Mr. Nair, amongst us, and may I request that the award be presented to him. May I request that the award be presented to him? Thank you, sir. This is a moment of great honor for all of us to have you here with us today. For the best cinematographer for documentary films in the national competition, here is what the jury had to say. "This cinematographer's work stands out for its reserved discipline, its beauty and attention to detail, and its overall contribution to the subtle tone of the film. The award for the best cinematographer for documentary films in the national competition goes to Soumyanand Sahi for Have You Seen the Aranam? Clip, please. I invite Soumyanand Sahi to come on stage to receive the award for the best cinematographer in the documentary film category of the national competition. Thank you, Mr. Sahi. The jury citation for the next award reads, "This editor made a complex story accessible, compelling, heart-wrenching, and ultimately inspiring." The award for Best Editor for Documentary Films in the National Competition goes to Jabeen Merchant for Invoking Justice. Can we have the clip, please? I welcome Jabeen Merchant to come on to stage to receive the award for Best Editor in the Documentary Film category for the national competition. This is Deepa Dhanraj, director of the film, taking this award. Thank you, ma'am. For best sound, the jury observed, rendered with great sensitivity and care, the sounds of the natural world and of the human voice are integral elements in bringing the director's vision and message to the screen. For this accomplishment, the award for Best Sound for Documentary Films in the National Competition goes to Christopher Burkle for Have You Seen the Arna? Can we have the clip, please? Christopher, unfortunately, could not make it to the ceremony. May I request the director of the film, Ms. Sunanda Bhatt, to come on stage to receive on his behalf the award for Best Sound in the Documentary Film category of the national competition. Thank you, ma'am. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we come to the golden conches for the documentary films in the national competition. A golden conch, along with the cash award of rupees 3 lakhs for the director and an award of rupees 2 lakhs for the producer of the winning film, is awarded in each of the two categories, documentaries up to 40 minutes and documentaries over 40 minutes. For the best documentary up to 40 minutes in the national competition, the golden conch has been awarded to, and the citation reads, a charming, ironic, and stylish film that introduces the world to a uniquely talented and remarkably prolific Assamese author. The award goes to 700007, directed by Altaf Mazid and produced by the Public Service Broadcasting Trust. Let us have a clip, please. I invite Sri Altaf Mazid to come on stage to receive the Golden Conch and Cash Awards for the best documentary of up to 40 minutes in the national competition. Mr. Mazid will collect both the awards since the producers are not present here. May I request you, sir, to come and say a few words to us, please? Sir, would you like to say a few words, please?
Thank you very much. I don't know what to say, but thank you all. This is my fifth time in MIF, and it is really great to have an award after so many years. Not that I come here to receive an award, but to come to Mumbai after every 2 years and to meet my friends, all colleagues, films division, everything. It is really great for me to be here, and I really dedicate my award to the documentary or short filmmakers of Assam and of the Northeast, because we don't have any structure or any facility or anything except DVC Pro. That too is only available in Guwahati. My friends here in the Northeast from Imphal and Mizoram and Nagaland, every time they have to come to Guwahati to do their mastering, because in big festivals they no longer accept mini DV. So I dedicate my award to them that they could come up in the future and show their films, and there are some remarkable films from the Northeast. I'm really great. I feel very privileged for this award. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. And thanks to PSBT, Rajiv Mehrotra, and he gave me a chance to keep this film, definitely a committee, but this is the first film for me with the PSBT. Thank you.
Our eminent jury faced a dilemma while deciding the winner for the best documentary over 40 minutes in the national competition. Ultimately, they ran out of options and generously decided to split the award between two films. Let me read out the jury citation to you for the first, or for both. The jury was not short of adjectives to praise this film: elegant, patient, mediative, and subtle. The director gently moves her audience towards a deep appreciation of the tribal, mythical connections between humanity and the ecosystems that sustain us all. The Golden Conch, the first Golden Conch, has been awarded to, and excuse my pronunciation, Ningal Aranya Kando, Have You Seen the Arana? Directed and produced by Sunanda Bhatt. Can we have the clip, please? I welcome Sunanda Bhatt to come on stage to receive the Golden Conch and the Cash Award of Rs. 2.5 lakhs for the best documentary of over 40 minutes in national competition. Ma'am, would you like to say a few words?
I don't think anybody will see me from behind the podium. I always face this problem. Okay, anyway, you'll hear my voice. Yeah, I'm delighted, really, truly delighted to receive this award because, you know, as I've mentioned in my, as it's mentioned in the catalog, I spent a long time trying to, you know, work on this film, find a way to bring in the complexity of both the people and the place. And now, after making the film, I go back repeatedly to Wayanad to do community screenings. I show the film among Adivasi communities. You know, it's a very nice raw kind of screening with just a sheet put up and basic sound. And at every screening, they ask me, how do the others react to our film? How does the outside world react to our film? And, you know, I'll be really happy now to go back and tell them the kind of appreciation the film has received, not only in terms of this award, but also in terms of the feedback after every screening, the kind of, the way people come, want to discuss the film and talk about it. So, jury members, thank you so much. I'm delighted to receive this.
Thank you, ma'am. The award for best documentary of over 40 minutes is shared equally by a film that throws sharp light on the culturally enshrined injustice. It participates with women who create a revolutionary challenge to male rule. With moving courage and compassion, the filmmaker and her subjects make history. The Golden Conch and Split Cash Award for the best documentary over 40 minutes also and equally goes to Invoking Justice, directed and produced by Deepa Dhanraj. Clip, please.
Sharifa Khanum started the Tamil Nadu Muslim Women's Jamaat in 2004 with a small group of women who are still active as leaders. They are spread out over 12 districts and the group now has 12,000 members. Most of these women are engaged in small trades.
I invite Deepa Dhanraj to come on stage to receive the Golden Conch and Cash Award for best documentary of over 40 minutes in national competition. Can we request you to say a few words?
I'd like to thank MIF for selecting the film, of course. But I think I'd really like to dedicate this award to the women of the Tamil Nadu Muslim Women's Jamaat for their indefatigable courage, their integrity, and their sense of humor. So this is for them.
Thank you, ma'am. Jury 2 also adjudged the short fiction films up to 45 minutes of the international competition section. We have 3 awards for technical excellence, each carrying a cash award of rupees 1 lakh and a certificate, that for the best cinematographer, the best editor, and the best sound. According to the jury, in the film awarded for best cinematography, creating a feeling of infinite space, the camera glides through 3 dimensions, animating every environment it enters and revealing the stamp of time on architecture. The award for best cinematography goes to Mindia Esadze for 9 into 9. Clip, please. Mindia Esadze could not make it to this ceremony. May I request a representative of the film or the consulate of Azerbaijan to come on stage to receive, on behalf of the awardee, the award for best cinematographer in the short film category of the international competition. For best editor, ladies and gentlemen, the award goes to a filmmaker whose work is almost a one-man show. He produced, directed, shot, recorded, and edited the film himself. And this editing determined the film's unique storytelling style. The award for best editor goes to Wing Yin Zito from Hong Kong for his film, Accident. Let us watch a clip, please. Friends, Wing Yin Zito is not here, which is fortunate for me because he cannot hear me butcher his name like this. But may I please request a representative from the Embassy of Hong Kong to please receive the award on behalf of the editor. People in embassies and consulates are busy people, so we will now come to the award for best sound. And the jury states, I quote, "The sound recording heightens the fluidity and grace of the visuals and emotions and plays a key role in constructing the audience's experience of time and space." The award for best sound goes to Dilip Kumar Ahivar for Black Box. Clip, please.
Mala model dakho na. Mi pahalas nahi.
Workshop lagi. थाम की
तुला खूप दगड हवेत का
ते फडतरे म्हणले आधीचा दगड चालणार नाही म्हणून
तो उभा दगड कसला मस्त आहे तो
उभा उभा
उभा
ऊ म्हण ऊ
I invite Mr. Dilip Kumar Ahivar, who I hope is here, to come on stage and receive the award for best sound in the short fiction film category of international competition. Oh, so we were hoping you or Mr. Ahivar, but. Well, congratulations to all the absent awardees. I think we should give them a loud round of applause so that they can hear us wherever they are. And now, the Golden Conch for Best Short Fiction Film in the International Competition, which carries a cash award of rupees 3 lakhs for the director and 2 lakhs for the producer. I want to be on that side now of this entire program. The playful, subtle, intense performances of the two young actors in this film produce a transcendent mood of togetherness and looming separation, a compelling story that will be appreciated by audiences in all corners of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, the Golden Conch for the best short fiction film in the international section goes to Black Rock, directed by Vikrant Janardhan Pawar and produced by FTII India. Let us watch a clip from the film, please.
काय मग नवीन मित्र नवीन चित्र नवीन कॅम्पस हे काय
चॉकलेट आहे
आय इन्व्हाइट विक्रांत जनार्दन पवार इफ ही इज हियर amongst us or a crew member from his film, if they are here, to come on stage to receive the Golden Conch and a cash award of rupees 3 lakhs from the director. And also Mr. DJ Narayan, director FTII, to receive Golden Conch and cash award of 2 lakhs for the producer, if they are here. Kundu sir, if nobody's here, I'm going to start taking the certificates and the checks especially. Everyone is from FTII over here. Thank you, and thank you, honorable members of jury too. May I request you to please have your seats in the audience, and Shyam sir and Adur sir, please wait on stage. Now we are on to the second leg of the award presentation. I join our excited audience, it says here. Clap for yourselves, create some excitement. I join our excited audience in inviting on stage jury one. Mr. Anand Patwardhan is one of the most important documentary filmmakers in our country today, whose tireless efforts in documentary filmmaking are exemplary. He is also the winner of the V. Shantaram Lifetime Achievement Award at this edition of MIF. Ms. Angela Hart is a curator, film scholar, and previously the festival director of the Oberhausen Film Festival. Ms. Fujioka Asako is the festival director of the Yamagata International Documentary Film Festival. Mr. Yuri Medin is a film scholar, writer, filmmaker, and programmer based in Slovenia. Ms. Shilpa Ranade is a globally acclaimed animation filmmaker who also teaches animation at the IIT Mumbai. May I please invite the jury chairman, Mr. Anand Patwardhan, to address the house.
Yeah, many of the remarks that Mark made apply to our jury as well, which is the international jury. But before I begin our introductory remarks, the juries of both the national and international sections would like to express our deep appreciation for the wonderful treatment we have received from the entire MIF 2014 team. And its dynamic and ever cheerful leader, Mr. V.S. Kundu. We have a small joint gift for everyone here in the MIF team, but we won't embarrass them by doing it on stage. Our jury looked at both short and long documentaries in the international section and all animation films, and also adjudicated the best debut award in all sections. Generally, we were very happy with the quality of films in the long documentary section, though somewhat puzzled at the exclusion of a few powerful contenders at the selection stage. As there were very few entries selected in the short documentary section, we, in consultation with MIF 2014, decided to increase the duration of this section from under 40 minutes to under 60 minutes. Both juries regretted the fact that there was no special jury award for us to give away. So in consultation again with the MIF team, our jury created a best director category in the technical awards. I would like to put on record that the discussions in our jury, which were made up for people from Japan, Germany, Slovenia, and India, brought a high level of expertise and experience to the table in a purely constructive way. In the end, we reached unanimous decisions with almost no compromises for anyone. I personally thank all the members of our jury for this. We are confident that once the mainstream media is more involved, and through it, the public at large is better informed, MIF will grow from strength to strength, strength to strength. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We now go on to the international competition section, adjudged by jury one. This category covers animation films and documentary films, both up to 40 minutes and above 40 minutes, or 60 minutes. I now invite Shri Adur Gopalakrishnan and Shri Shyam Benegal to please present the following awards, beginning with the animation section. The jury felt that one film from the animation section deserved to be honored with a special mention certificate. The citation reads, a well-executed, bold, educational film about child sexual abuse, a subject that has remained taboo to the detriment of its victims. The certificate of honorable mention goes to the film Amlu, directed by Swaroop Deb. Clip, please.
Jadoo.
I invite Mr. Deb to please come on stage to take his certificate of merit. Thank you, Swaroop. We now proceed to the two technical awards in the animation section, each carrying a certificate and a cash award of rupees 1 lakh, that for the best animator and the best sound. In a world of cosmetic imagery, this film comes straight from the gut of the animator in a truly remarkable, original and raw personal work. One can savor every disturbing line of the pencil, jagged and torn edge of paper and uneven stroke of the brush. The dark, intuitive animation mirrors and expresses the fascination for the dance form of a forbidden caste. The award for the best animator goes to Ranjita Rajivan for Kelly. Can we have a clip, please? I invite Ranjita Rajivan to please come on stage to receive the cash award of 1 lakh and a certificate for best animator. Thank you and congratulations, Ranjita. For the best sound in the animation category, the jury citation reads, the film has an atmospheric soundtrack that goes from being a sparse and percussive from being sparse and percussive into being a complex web of sounds and music as its intricate oral scape seamlessly telescopes back to a stark beginning, adding greatly to the mystery of this unusual film. Very eloquent jury. The award goes to Janmeet Singh for the sound in the film Kacho Ghadulo, directed by Shivangi Ranawat and Pranay Patwardhan. Clip, please. We have the third directors of the film Saptesh to come and collect the award. And now, friends, for the Golden Conch for Best Animation Film of MIFF 2014. And the citation says, real-life love on the street and larger-than-life Bollywood cinema share the same intense drama in this abundantly saturated film. Heightened emotion blends easily into extreme fiction, only to fall apart at an instant where fact cannot follow the untiring, giddy fantasy anymore. The film's fine storytelling and startling imagery draws one to its heart-wrenching, well-etched characters in an exceptionally detailed, ironic, and compelling narrative. The Golden Conch for the best animation film goes to True Love Story by Geetanjali Rao. Clip, please. May I invite the brilliant Geetanjali Rao to come on stage to receive the Golden Conch and a cash award of rupees 5 lakhs as director and producer of the best animation film. That's two awards, friends, the benefit and burden of being both the director and producer of the film. Can we request you to say a few words?
Thank you very much. I'm very grateful to the jury and everybody, the 125 people in Films Division and the 100 volunteers who have made this festival so great, and it's great for us as animators. And I would like my entire team, which is here, which has supported me in making this film, to please stand up and take a bow. Vishruta, Sangeeta, Rekha, Manoj, my mother. Thanks to them, I have made this film. Thank you very much.
Congratulations, Geetanjali. Now for the documentary section of the international competition, we have a special mention of a very courageous film. The jury states, and I quote, "If there was a prize in this festival for courage and determination to follow a story to its logical conclusion, this film would get it. As it is, the jury would like to acknowledge the film for its unwavering look at labor camps in the UAE and the denial of basic principles of injustice. The award of honorable mention goes to 17 Not Required Indians, directed by Sonia Kriplani. The award carries a certificate of merit. May I please invite Sonia Kriplani to come on stage and receive the award for honorable mention.
I truly want to know, what's happening to 17 Indians on death row in Sharjah. And if we don't give them a fair trial, we lose 17 Indians to weak representation. And that is something as a human being I can't accept.
Thank you, ma'am. There are three technical awards, each carrying a certificate and a cash award of rupees 1 lakh, that for best cinematographer, best editor, and the best sound design for the documentary films entered in the international competition. As you are aware, the jury did not find any film sound enough for an award for the best sound and decided to award the best director of a documentary in the international competition section. The citation reads, "For a beautifully shot, powerfully conceived and executed work that brings us face to face with the reality of a patriarchal society where the murder of women is commonplace. The film introduces us to women who resist the system even as they deal with the complexity and conflict within their own group. The award for best direction in a documentary film goes to Nishita Jain for the film Gulabi Gang. Clip, please. Sorry, that's Nishita Jain, best director for a documentary film. Oh, would you like to say a few words? For best cinematographer, the jury citation says, an exquisite eye for both detail and panorama, for both human face and vistas of muddy waters, immerses the viewer completely as it confronts what could only be called a terrible beauty. And the award goes to Kamar Ahmed Simon for the film Are You Listening? Clip, please. May I please invite Kamar Ahmed Simon to come up on stage and receive the cash award of 1 lakh and a certificate for best cinematographer. Thank you, Kamar. The jury chose for the Best Editor Award a film in which striking black and white images convey the abstract beauty of chess inside the blind boy's extraordinary minds. Masterful arrangement of what must have been vast quantities of material spreading over years and continents creates an almost palpable sense of suspense, bringing us closer to the protagonists and enabling us to share their disappointments and hopes. And the award for the best editor goes to Ajit Kumar B. and Ian McDonald for the film Algorithms, a film produced by Geeta J. and directed by Ian McDonald. Clip, please.
that's it. Everybody gets tense. For one or two days, I feel like I should not play further. It's better to concentrate on studies, but then, as you know, time with time everything gets recovered, so again.
I invite Ajit Kumar B and Ian McDonald to come on stage and receive the cash award of ₹50,000 each and a certificate for best editor. And they will both be taken by him. Thank you, Ian. For documentary films in the international competition, a golden conch along with cash award of ₹3 lakhs for the director and an award of ₹2 lakhs for the producer of the winning film is given in each of the two categories, documentaries up to 60 minutes and documentaries over 60 minutes. In documentaries up to 60 minutes, according to the jury, and I quote, "This film of exceptional quality is the story of one man's gift of music that creates a bridge across the seemingly insurmountable gap between North and South Korea. It also gives the viewer a rare entry into North Korea, where the camera silently encounters both state control and human emotions that are universal. The golden conch for the best documentary film up to 60 minutes goes to In Between, Ah Sang-yoon in North and South Korea. Produced by Paul Maxini and Maria Stodmeyer. Clip, please. The German filmmakers Paul Maxini and Maria Stodmeyer could not make it to this ceremony. May I request Mr. Martin Walde, director of the Goethe Institute, to please come on stage to receive on their behalf the award for the best documentary film up to 60 minutes of the international competition. Thank you, Mr. Walde. And now we present the golden conch for the best documentary film above 60 minutes in international competition. May I request Ms. Angela Hart to please receive the award for In Between on behalf of Paul Maxini and Maria Stodmeyer.
It's just because I'm living in Berlin and the filmmaker in Leipzig, which is only an hour by train away, so I can take it.
The Golden Conch for Best Documentary Film Above 60 Minutes in International Competition, the citation reads, "Careful, patient, and respectful observation, bordering on meditation almost, brings us closer to a certain struggle, ending in a triumph of solidarity and an affirmation of the unbreakable in human spirit. Moments of exquisite beauty punctuate the film as its long-term commitment to the people filmed affirms the extraordinary power of concerted labor, as well as the fragile lives of individuals with their daily joys and fears, living on the outpost as yet another natural assault threatens to engulf them. The world can ignore them at its own peril." And the golden conch for the best documentary film above 60 minutes goes to Are You Listening?, directed, photographed, and edited by Kamar Ahmed Simon and produced by Sara Afreen. I invite Kamar Ahmed Simon to come on stage. Oh, sorry, clip, please. May I invite Kamar Ahmed Simon to come on stage to receive the golden conch and a cash award of rupees 3 lakhs as director, and Sara Afreen to receive the golden conch and a cash award of rupees 2 lakhs as producer of the film for best documentary above 60 minutes in international competition. Please accept the award on behalf of the producer as well. Thank you, Kamar. May I please request the members of Jury 1 to take their seats? And Adur sir and Sham sir to please remain on stage. So you have to give out a couple more awards. You can take a We shall now be presenting the special awards of MIFF 2014. The best student film is given to a chosen film from the national competition and carries the IDPA trophy and a cash award of rupees 1 lakh. I request Arur sir to hand out the award for best student film and request Sri Dinkar Chaudhary, Vice President IDPA, to please join us on stage.
शंकरला आश्चर्यच वाटलं आणि तो विचारात पडला, आता काय करायचं या आंब्यांचं? ते सगळे सोन्याचे आंबे विकायला तो तालुक्याच्या गावी आला आणि त्या मिळणाऱ्या पैशामधून त्याला खूप सारी आंब्याची झाडं लावायची होती.
That was Golden Mango, awarded the best student film. The jury citation reads that with an evident passion for visual storytelling, this delightful metaphoric film has a lesson for young and old about what constitutes wealth. For a film that's as sweet as a ripe mango, the award's gone to The Golden Mango, directed by Govinda Raju. I invite Mr. Raju to please come on stage and take the cash award and the IDPA trophy.
Hi, I'm not Govind Raju, but I accept this. He's a wonderful filmmaker and wonderful friend, and so fortunate to take this on his behalf. He'll be very, very happy and would want to thank you. Thank you.
Our next award is the Dada Saheb Phalke Chitra Nagari Award for the best debut film of a director. And this is given to a chosen film from the international competition, and carries a trophy and cash award of rupees 1 lakh. I invite Shisham Benegal to hand out the award for Best Debut Film of a Director and request Managing Director Dada Saheb Phalke Chitranagari to join me on stage. Please don't show the clip yet. The jury was impressed by, and I quote, an amazing feat for the first time for a first-time filmmaker who organizes well-researched and compelling evidence to expose how the corporate world of pharma is complicit in the genocidal murder of those who are priced out of existence. Its direct approach builds an argument that is not only striking, revealing, and outrageous, but simply necessary. The jury wishes to add that had this not been a first-time film, we would still have found a way to award it. That deserves a round of applause, friends. The award for Best Debut Film of a Director goes to Fire in the Blood, produced, directed, and edited by Dylan Mohan Gray. Clip, please.
If it is true that one death is a tragedy and a million deaths a statistic, while the death toll in Africa continued to rise, AIDS was now largely seen as old news in the West.
I invite Mr. Dylan Mohan Gray to please come on stage and receive the cash award of rupees 1 lakh and a trophy for the best debut film of a director. Thank you and bravo, Dylan. From this edition of MIFF 2014, a new award has been instituted after one of the most important formal innovators in documentary filmmaking, Shri Pramod Pathy. Shri Pramod Pathy studied animation at FAMU in Prague and thereafter joined Films Division in 1959 as head of the animation unit. His pioneering experimental work established him as a global film artist. His untimely demise at the young age of 43 years robbed the nation and the world of a great master. The Pramod Pathy Award for the most innovative film celebrates transcendence of conventional cinematic boundaries and is awarded to a film chosen from both national and international competition. It carries a trophy and a cash award of rupees 1 lakh. I now invite noted filmmaker and selection committee member, Ms. Madhushree Datta, to please come on stage to present the award for the most innovative film of MIFF 2014. Ms. Datta. The jury citation for the award reads, for its penetrating, unblinking, up-close and personal interview technique, and for its persistent, caste-busting pursuit of insight and understanding. The award for the most innovative film goes to Decision, directed by Pushpa Rawat. Clip, please.
अगर मैं नहीं मानती
मानती तो मेरे को क्या बता रहे हो नहीं मानती करके खुद अपना दिमाग होना चाहिए बच्चे को आजकल इसीलिए पढ़ा रखा है माँ बाप ने
I invite Ms. Pushpa Rawat to please come on stage and receive the cash award of rupees 1 lakh and a trophy for the Pramod Pathy Award for the most innovative film.
Sorry, ये award मैं अनुपमा मैम के साथ लेना चाहूँगी अकेले नहीं. Please, ma'am, come, please.
पुष्पा जी आप कुछ शब्द कहना चाहेंगे?
थैंक यू मिस, थैंक यू जूरी एंड थैंक यू अनुपमा मैम जिन्होंने मुझे चांस दिया. सोचा नहीं था कभी दिस इज माय फर्स्ट डॉक्यूमेंट्री फिल्म और यहाँ पे पहुँचूंगी. शब्द नहीं है मेरे पास. सभी का थैंक यू, धन्यवाद.
In the 13th edition, MIFF decided to involve the audiences in awarding a film through award for most popular film, which carries a trophy and cash award of rupees 1 lakh. Two ballot boxes were kept in the premises and numbered voting cards were issued to the delegates. Frankly, we had hoped for a far more enthusiastic response. The voting closed at 11 p.m. on the 8th of February, and on the basis of the votes cast, the counting was done under the supervision of a committee consisting of Ms. Prabha Mahajan and Ms. Monica Vahi. May I invite noted filmmaker and convener of the International Selection Committee, Ms. Aruna Rajepatil, to please come on the stage to present the award for the most popular film at MIFF 2014. The award for the most popular film of MIFF 2014 on the basis of votes cast goes to The Vicious Circle, directed by Ms. Dhwani Desai. I invite Ms. Dhwani Desai to please come on the stage.
पर आरटीआई की ताकत ही इतनी है कि सब प्राप्त हुआ, रुके हुए अधूरे काम भी पूरे हो सकते हैं. अब तो कोई समस्या ही नहीं और सरकार भी हमारे साथ है तो क्या चिंता. चलो सिर्फ आरटीआई का फॉर्म ही तो भरना है.
The supervision committee consisted of Ms. Uma Dukuna, Ms. Prabha Mahajan, and Ms. Monica Vahi. After that whirlwind of an awards ceremony, for me especially, I now take a moment to look at my pages again. Adur sir would like to address the audience again. Sir?
Sorry to come back. I started a story, but I forgot to end it. So this girl was following me all the day. I took pity on her, you know. She's so intent on this. I she's like my daughter, or even cannot be granddaughter, but then maybe daughter. So I said, okay, you ask me questions, I will try to answer. So it's very difficult to answer questions when the person who asks questions doesn't know what she or he is asking. So I try to make some sense out of what she asked and then try to answer her. And then finally said, oh, thank you very much. And I was walking off. Then she called me from the back again and she asked me, I said, yes, now what? Sir, may I know your name, please?
Thank you, sir. We now come to the concluding moments of the festival. I take this opportunity to acknowledge and thank the filmmakers, academics, producers, organizations, and cinephiles who helped make MIFF 2014 a truly memorable and inspiring festival. The Indian Documentary Producers Association has been a steady partner of the Films Division of India in organizing MIFF from its inception. I welcome the Vice President of IDPA, Sridhankar Chaudhary, and request him to propose a vote of thanks, please.
Namaskar to everybody. The person who proposes the vote of thanks becomes overconscious and nervous, as I am today, just because of an undercurrent fear that some name should not be missed or some name should not be wrongly pronounced. So I tender my apology before, and I think, before I say, I think you have accepted my decision. First of all, on behalf of MIF, we thank Mr. Shri Shyam Benegal. No need introduction. He needs no introduction. But certainly he is one of the pillars of Indian cinema, and everybody knows. We are very proud to have him here as a chief guest. And another pillar and another legend, Mr. Adur Gopalakrishnan, for consenting to be as a guest of honor today. Before, in the opening ceremony, our Honorable Governor of Maharashtra, Shri K. Shankar Narayan ji, we must thank him for sparing his time for that. We would like to thank Honorable Minister for Information and Broadcasting, Shri Manish Tiwari, for guiding and mentoring us throughout for the successful conduct of the festival. Of course, it is a big list, but I will finish it before you can vote. Honorable Minister for Culture, Department of Culture, Sri Sanjay Deutale, for all the help, especially for the grant in aid for MIF. We especially thank Secretary, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Sri Bimal Jhulka, for his constant guidance and support as chairman of the organizing committee of MIF 2014. Joint Secretary Films, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Sri Raghavendra Singh, for all his help and guidance throughout the festival. And also we thank all the honorable members of the organizing committee and all senior officers of Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Government of India. We thank Managing Director Dada Saab Phalke Chitranagri and his team for hosting the MIF and instituting an award. Members of jury number 1 and 2 have done a commendable job and a very, very difficult job and tedious job for selecting the films and to judging process to judge the merits from all corners. So we especially thank for jury number 1 and 2. Of course, before that jury selection committee, members are there who have seen all the films and selected some films. So we thank all the selection committee members for devoting much of their time in selecting films for competition and presenting them. We also thank Press Information Bureau for helping with extensive coverage of the MIF and for manning the media center. Doordarshan for wide coverage and live telecast of the events. Akashvani, especially the FM station, for wide coverage of the festival. DAVP for advertising the festival all over the country through print media. Social media cell of Ministry of Information and Broadcasting for live streaming of the festival. BMC, we thank BMC and BEST for their support. Indian Railways, Valmay Lorry Company Limited, Indian Oil Corporation. We also thank various partners who have helped and supported this festival. Cube Cinema and Real Image Network for digital projection system. Lineup Media and Lineup Kids Fest and Workshop. Action Aid India, Mr. Mukul Kishore and Ms. Saurabhi Sharma, Mr. Robin Becker of British Film Institute, Consulate General of Canada, Dr. Martin Balde and Jayashree Joshi of Goethe Institute and Max Muller Bhavan. MIF Zone partners in various cities of India. Mr. Javed Jafri and Ms. Sophie Shivaraman for organizing Good Pitch Squad. Ms. Rashmi Lamba and Shaili Bhatte for organizing MIF Hub. Aparna Sanyal and Mr. Shyam Bora for organizing Producers Forum. Mr. Rajiv Puri of Whistling Woods International for Students Volunteers. Bombay Police, Indian Customs, Indian Navy for the Naval Band Performances. Ms. Gargi Sen for organizing. Mr. Nilot Pal Mazumdar for organizing it. Panelists of the Open Forum and panel discussions, curators and presenters of all these special packages, homebyfreedom.com for the kit bags, Mr. Shivendra Singh Dungarpurkar for master class on digital archiving, Abhijit Mukul Kishore and FD zone coordinators for unconferencing and audience development, Ms. Nicole Wolf for package from Arsenal, Berlin, Mr. Shekhar Mukherjee of NID, Mr. Neil Sadvelkar for conducting workshops, NCPA chairman and his entire team. Last but not the least, the very important, that all the delegates coming from India and abroad, national, international, all the delegates who have made this film alive, this festival alive throughout the week. All delegates, we thank all the delegates, filmmakers, film lovers, and the award winners who have won award today. As it is said that most important thing, we have all the persons who are present here, who have assembled here, accepted our invitation and attended the opening ceremony as well as closing ceremony. We thank them all very much. And before that, I will just, not in the end, but I will say, above all, we will thank Almighty God for blessing the festival a grand success. Thank you very much. Yes, as I said, this is very, very closer to Madam Isham name. For bulletin, Dr. Shruti Goyal, we thank her very much and sorry that I missed her name. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. That doesn't matter. I'm going to take my own name. Thank you, sir. I'm going to take my own name in a bit. Friends, it's now time to say goodbye to all our Doordarshan viewers who have been tuning in live to watch the closing ceremony of MIF 2014. Good night, friends.